What is your reaction to this idea of contagion? What does a genesis, for example, represent of what is happening in this industry?
Yeah, so I think in the last 2 years, we saw this extreme growth in centralized lenders. So these are lenders like Genesis, BlockFi, Celsius. And what they did is they gave sort of unsecured loans to market makers, for the most part, from the borrowing side. And then they took deposits from consumers or institutions in the case of Genesis. And we, during kind of the zero interest rate world, we saw an extension of credit to, you know, parties that otherwise were perhaps not really credit worthy, with very little collateral requirements at all. And this amount of uncollateralized lending on paper produced a huge number of profits for decentralized lenders. However, of course, as rates tightened, the centralized lenders were sort of unable to keep the capital that they needed to issue these loans. And the people that who they'd sort of lent to had owned and gone extremely long cryptocurrencies, especially ones that crashed, such as Luna. And that led to this sort of extreme credit crunch that we're seeing right now. In a lot of ways, the centralized lenders started all of the problems, and I guess it's sort of fitting that they're sort of the end of the contagion.
Well, here, I mean, Tarun, how far does the contagion then go now that we have new firms that are saying that they're pausing withdrawals? It's unclear how far that goes and who all those counterparties might be.
Yeah, for sure. I think the interesting thing about the lending books for a lot of these lenders is the majority of the borrowers were market-making firms, you know, more traditional market-making firms, sort of like the Jumps, GSRs, Jane Street, et cetera. As well as sort of these, you know, Alameda type of market makers who went under. And I think the real question of contagion from here really boils down to how well did these centralized lenders choose the loan to values, like how much they lent relative to the collateral, and what collateral do their counterparts actually have? Mm-hmm. In the case of Alameda, we kind of saw a lot of, you know, what I would call very similar to Enron's fall type of collateral, where there's collateral that's marked to billions of dollars, that whose, you know, real liquid market cap is, you know, $50 to $60 million versus being billions of dollars.
And so
that's the problem.
Tarun, I'm really curious here if we can kind of like look past what's happening day to day here and look forward 6 months into the future. Yeah. What does the industry look like?
I think the industry definitely moves towards decentralized finance quite a bit more. In decentralized finance, you could effectively think of it as customers can always withdraw, and they withdraw ahead of shareholders slash token holders. The idea that withdrawals are prioritized over shareholders sort of ensures that you don't have these kind of credit crunches built into the system. Now, that means you're more collateralized, but clearly the under-collateralized and less collateralized parts of the system all blew up at the same time. And mm-hmm. I think we're trending towards a more collateralized world in crypto, at least in probably the next 1 to 2 years, unless, you know, sort of rates go down again.
Tarun, if you look at the dislocations that are in the industry right now in certain assets, if you look at GBTC, if you look at the yields on staked Ether, if you look at, for example, the differential between Bitcoin futures and Bitcoin spot, if you look across the industry, what are the pricing dislocations that worry you?
Certainly GBTC is probably the largest worry, you know, with the GBTC discount to fair value at around -40%. I suspect there's quite a bit of a relation between the Genesis sort of halting and the GBTC premium blowing out. They're both sort of run by the same parent company, TCG, Digital Currency Group. And there's a lot of close relationships between them. For instance, 3 Arrows Capital used GBTC as collateral with Genesis to borrow against it. And, you know, obviously Genesis is now sitting on a 40% loss, as well as the borrowed assets are sort of gone. So I think the main question of the rest of the credit crisis is what collateral do people actually have? And in DeFi, everyone knows what collateral everyone has. And that's the difference.